Hi everyone, my name is Anderson. Today I'm going to demonstrate what is a good way to select a water gun. Okay, so here I have a water gun. Okay, so this is a syringe. Okay, and I have three different heads. I want to make sure that I want to select one head is that it can just let me shoot the target with the least amount of force I need to apply on the syringe. Okay, so the first one, I have a short head like this, is a very short tube. And the second one, I have maybe a slightly longer head. And the third one, I have a super long head like this. Okay, so if you have no idea which one works the best, then let's do an experiment. So in this experiment, what you need is very simple. The first one is a water gun, which can be whatever you like. But in this experiment, I just use a syringe. And the second one you need is the tube of different length. Okay, so let's do an experiment. Okay, so what we'll do is just attach the tube onto the syringe, okay, and then I suck the water, and then I shoot the target. Yes. Okay, I shoot it. Okay, so this one I can shoot pretty easily. How about the second? Wow, it's even hard to suck the water. Okay, and then I send at the same distance and shoot it. Hey, it looks like it's stronger, it's easier to get a target, right? But you see, wow, I need to apply a stronger force to shoot the water with the same speed. Okay, and third, let's get the longest one. Okay, let's get some water. Wow, it's even hard to get the water in. How about I just catch it and do it again? Okay, let's do it. Wow, this one is really long. Wow! Oh, it's even hard for me to shoot the wall, right? Yeah, so based on this experiment, you can conclude that selecting the short tube is your best choice to shoot the target easily. Okay? As for the reason, this is because of something called the head loss of the pipe flow. It's that when the water is flowing in the pipe like this, okay, it's because of the friction of the pipe wall and also the water viscosity itself, when the longer it flows, the larger the energy is dissipated. So that means we need to apply a larger pressure to let the water jet at the same speed for the longer tube compared to the small tube. Okay, so that is called the head loss of the pipe flow. And you can imagine if this pipe flow system is over pressure, then it will explode. So that's why you can always see that on the road, there are some pipes that explode. This is because of this reason. It's that they want to transport the water to your house, but they overpressure the pipe and then they explode. Okay, so that's the whole pipe flow demonstration. And also, I want to tell you a secret. It's that in our lab, in Professor Kunta Wu's lab at WPI, we invented a kind of fluid that can overcome the barrier of the pipe flow. That is, there's a kind of fluid that exhibit zero head loss in the pipe flow. If you want to find out the detail, just visit our website. You can find our website, just simply Google WPI Wu Lab. Okay, thank you.